Let's add some text to our document. We'll start with the sources text at the bottom of the infographic. So I'm going to the resources folder, and there is a Word document with the text and data. I'm going to select the text that goes with the sources and artwork and copy that. Go back into Illustrator. I'm going to zoom in on the bottom of the page, choose the type tool. Before I drag out a text box, I need to create a new layer. So I'm going to make a new layer, and we can name this artwork. On our new layer, let's drag out a text box, and I'm just going to drag from the left guideline to the right guideline, and I'm going to choose Command V and paste in the text. We need to style the text. I'm going to go to my window menu and choose type and bring up the character window. I could also hit Command T, and I'm going to do a zoom in first. Make sure all of our text is selected, and we're going to choose Avenir Next for the font, and regular, and let's choose, well, we have 12 for the size, that's correct, and for the leading, let's choose 18. Now for the tracking, we're going to choose minus 25, or I'm just going to type that in. And then we're going to make the names of any publications italic, because that's the proper way to indicate a publication. And since livescience.com, even though it's a website is a publication. So we're going to choose italic for that, and then also for the pet ownership and demographic source book, let's choose italic for that. Make sure you get all of the letters in the title. And we just want to align this with our guide. So I'm just going to resize this text box so that it aligns with this guide. And I want to make sure that it extends to the left and right guides. And if we want to take a look at our layout, without the guides in the way, we can choose on the Mac, we can choose Command semicolon, and that will hide the guides just to make sure that everything looks good. And what I forgot to do is for sources, let's make that demi-bold, and we'll make artwork demi-bold. And I'm including the colon with that. All right, so let's add some more text. So the title of this infographic is Cats versus Dog, but there's a descriptive subtitle which is called Pet Ownership in the United States. So we're going to add that subtitle in. So let's go back to our text tool. I'm going to drag out another text box. I'm going to put the cap locks on and type in pet ownership. I'm going to hit return and then turn the cap locks off. And I'm going to just zoom in a bit. Type in the, and then we can put the cap locks back on and type in United States in all caps. So I'm going to style the pet ownership text. That's also Avenir Next. We're going to choose heavy for that. The size is 60 points. The leading, we'll set leading for this. We'll make that 45. And then the tracking is negative 25, so that's already set. For in the United States, let's make this ultra light. And for the size, we'll make this 54 points. For the leading, we'll make that 45. And then the tracking, again, is negative 25, so it stays the same. All right, and now what we need to do is get out of the type tool and just resize this box a little bit. And we're going to place this so that the top of the ownership text is aligned with this rule, and the bottom of the United States text is aligned with this rule. And I am going to put in a few spaces here so that the I is directly under the T in PET. And I'm going to select all, and I'm going to choose a new color for this. Let's make this a purple color. So I'm typing in BC8EA1. You can see a nice purple color there. Actually, let's do this now. So now that I have my purple color, I'm going to click and drag the swatch and add it to my swatches. And then we're also going to use a pink color on this. So I'm going to Command C to copy and then Shift Command V to paste in place. So what I've done is I've pasted one copy of the text directly over the original. If I select the text with my type tool and Command A, what I'm doing is I'm selecting all of the text in the copy. And I'm going to go back to the fill swatch, and I'm going to type in my pink color, which is DD8172. And I'll deselect that so you can see it. I'm going to add the swatch to my swatches panel because I'm going to need that again. And so if I drag this away, I can see that I've got the original text, which is in purple, and the copy, which is in pink. Let me Command Z to undo that. So you want these directly on top of each other. And with the pink text selected, I'm going to go to my transparency tab, and for the blend mode, instead of normal, I'm going to choose multiply, and it's going to make a kind of a dark red color. Let me zoom out so that we can see where we're at. All right, we've got our pet ownership in the United States text, and we have our source text, and we're ready to move on to the next step.